let it rain. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. My God, the Bible said in James that the husbandman, he's got long patience. And he's awaiting for the precious fruit of the earth. How many believe that you coming on into the fullness of God is some of that freshness? He's Elah, a whole Shatai, hallelujah. That's some of that fresh anointing. He's awaiting the sons of God to wake up with a new fire and a new glory on their head. Wipe the sleep out of their eyes. Shake that dust off of them. Put on your beautiful garments, old Zion, and sing a new song unto the Lord. Hallelujah. And he said he's got great patience.
Yes,
amen. And he's awaiting something. He's awaiting the earth to receive of both the early and the latter rain. Lord, how many believe there's a rain of word and spirit? It's getting ready to hit it one time. It ain't going to be rain a month and recuperate and then get the next rain. It's going to rain till it floods. And it's going to flood till it rises. And it's going to rise until it washes. And it's going to wash until it carries us away. Hallelujah. And there's no such thing as having too much Holy Ghost. No such thing as getting too lost in the glory. No such thing as getting too overcome. If you don't mind, I'd just soon be so spiritually minded that I was no earthly good. I don't want to be no earthly good. I want to live from another place. I want to talk from another dimension. I want to preach from another realm. I don't want to preach to people on the level they're on. I want to get up above that level. Oh, glory to God. John heard a voice say, come up hither. He heard a voice above him that called him upward. It ain't doing you no good for people to converse with you, talk with you on the same level. You need to go meet somebody that's on a higher level.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Praise God. Some folks need your Wizard of Oz. They can't find no help where they're at. They need another dimension. They need another realm. They need somebody that's got the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And Ezekiel said, the word of the Lord came unto me expressly. And I tell you, tonight's a fine night for the Spirit to start expressing himself. Can you say praise the Lord? Ooh, everybody ain't part of the sons of the prophets. Somebody's part of Elisha.
Right.
Them old sons can hide all they want to, but there's one man going to break the code. He's going to break the rules. Everybody that breaks the law gets a miracle. The woman with the issue of blood broke the law and got a miracle. Can you say amen? The man at the pool of Bethesda, the pool of Bethesda, broke the law. He got up and carried his bed on a Sunday. The man at the pool of Siloam. Every major event in Jesus' life that reveals to us our liberty, he did it on the Sabbath.
Yeah.
That's right. He broke corn on the Sabbath. And they said, you can't break no corn on the Sabbath. And he said, ain't you never read where David went in the temple and said, have you got any bread? And the priest said, they ain't got no normal bread.
Right.
You're going to run out of normal bread. Man can't live by bread alone. Ooh, he's got to live by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God. He said, I ain't got no regular bread, but I got holy bread.
Yes.
And said, if y'all ain't been defiling yourselves with nobody else, no other woman, that's talking about religion. Said, if you ain't full of religion, you can throw down all them laws and come in here and eat. They did. They did. And the Bible said David got his strength back and said, ain't you got no weapons? He said, no, I ain't got the one thing. What is it? He said, I got the sword you killed Goliath with. Hallelujah. Wrapped in a linen ephod. He is back here. David said, glory to God. Give it here and turn me loose. Glory. They came back and killed that priest.
Yeah, that's right.
Because he fed David. But while they was killing the priest, God gave David a new bride.
He sure did.
Her name was Abigail. Praise the Lord. Remember that story? Some of you look like you don't have a clue what I'm talking about. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord tonight. You remember Abigail, don't you? Her husband said, I wouldn't give him a crust of bread if the whole bunch starved to death. And his wife overheard it. I believe the wife's overhearing some things in this hour. She run on in there and said, he ain't going to curse me. Glory to God. I'm going in there and get me some figs and raisins. And she loaded up on fruit and loaded up on grain and cakes. Brought them out there and bowed down before David and said, David, I know who you are. You're the anointed of the Lord. And I won't be a part of casting you out of my house. And it wasn't but a few days her old man was gone, brother. He was just a story. But Abigail was took home by David. Can you say amen? Now don't you see that? There's a son and a church, a son and a bride coming together in a new way of living, new way of eating. New way of living, new way of eating. That's all what man cannot live by bread alone.
Amen, that's right.
He cannot live by natural sustenance all the time. He's got to have spirit food to build him up. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. I don't eat that sustenance of the earth. It's poison. That's what the serpent feeds on dust.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It comes in a different form now. CNN.
Yeah.
And news today and all this stuff, people eat that and all they do is spew poison. But man can't live by that. He's got to live by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Fresh word. You can't hold that manna. You'll try it, it won't work. It'll get worms every time. And there's folks now having to spit out worms every time they go to church and get fed. They spit out worms. Because they're eating old manna. But Jesus said, Revelation, John heard the voice said, I'll give to eat of that hidden manna. That kind that don't never grow old.
Glory to God.
That fresh bread.
Yes.
That new meal for today. Give us this day. Amen. Our daily bread. How many of you believe God's got daily revelation for you to walk in? And every night you go to bed, you ought to know more about Jesus than he did the day before. Can you say amen? Well, praise the Lord. We used to sing, of course, I ain't going to sing no more, but I sure could sing all night this anointing. We used to sing, I stand for Jesus. Let the world go by. How many remembers that song? I'll claim his promise. Oh, praise the Lord. He will supply. We'll walk together. My Lord and I'll stand for Jesus. Let the world go by. Hallelujah. In other words, I'll take my stand in truth. I'll feast at the table of the King and bless God while everybody else is rummaging around trying to find a little morsel of something. I'm going to have me a table spread. Glory to God. He prepared me a table in the presence of mine enemies. How many is glad already you've come to church tonight? Praise the Lord. We bless you so much. In the name of the Lord. Amen. Gail, bless you. I love you. It's so good to see you back and well in the house of the Lord tonight. You look wonderful. Praise the Lord. And I bless you for being here. God bless your heart. Amen. It's just good to see all of you here tonight. Amen. We're going to worship the Lord with our giving right now. If you'd bring it to the front and put it in the place, we bless you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Back on in the word on this matter of the ministry of Elijah and Elisha. and preaching to you on CNN to the invisible. Amen. And if you can see the invisible, you can do the impossible. Amen. And we got a ministry coming on. That's the reason I'm preaching to you about it. We got a ministry coming on right now, raising up in the earth. Well, glory to God that's got us eyes to see into another world. Amen. And we're going to read, we haven't yet read out of 2 Kings 2. We've been reading out of, what is it, 1 Kings 19, wasn't it? We've been reading, we're going to read in 2 Kings 2. And it came to pass, when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. And Elijah said to Elisha, "Tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord sent me to Bethel." And he said, "As the Lord liveth and my soul liveth, oh glory to God, I will not leave thee." Now do you understand you won't go nowhere that your soul's not committed to? Because your soul, if not made to come on into the oneness of your spirit, will talk you out and reason you out of everything in God. Can you say amen? Your soul is unfaithful lover till it's brought under the submission of the headship of the male part, which is the spirit of man. Spirit in the Bible is the male part. Masculine. Soul is the feminine part. And the man is the head of every woman, not talking about men ruling their wives with an iron fist. It's talking about you bringing your soul under submission to your spirit. How many of you realize that? Praise the Lord. Let the women keep silent in the church. Don't let the soul reason you out of the truth of God. While a man of God is woman of God giving you the word of the Lord, your soul will talk about everything but the truth. It'll talk about dishes. It'll talk about sales. It'll talk about whoever you're mad at. It'll talk about what you're going to do when you get home. Don't let the woman rule the house. Let the man rule the house. Let the Spirit of Christ rule you and dominate you. She's an unfaithful lover. She'll have an affair with the flesh quick as she will the spirit if she's allowed to. Praise the Lord. And then you got folks that get over in that sensual realm and worship only out of that soul worship. Hello. And any worship other than the Father in spirit and in truth is idolatry. I don't care where it's going on. And I don't care how long you've been saved. You can only go as far as you'll allow your soul to come under the domination of the Holy Ghost. And you can't prosper nor be in health any other way than as your soul prospers. And so Elijah said, "As I, the Lord God, liveth, and as my soul liveth." I've even geared my soul in on this one. I'm not going to wander. I'm not going to waver. If you go into Bethel, I'm going to Bethel. Then Elijah said a few verses down, said, "You better tarry here. I'm going to Jericho." He said, "No, as the Lord thy God liveth and my soul liveth, I'll go with thee to Jericho." And then he said, "Come on, God." He said, "You stay here in Jericho while I go to Jordan." There ain't too many people that go to Jordan because they fear death. Don't believe they got power over it. They don't believe Jesus overcome it. Praise the Lord. How do you know? Because they all believe they've got to die.
Yes,
and rot away. They don't believe in incorruption. I'm preaching better than you're shouting now. The Sadducees said, "There ain't nothing, no resurrection. There isn't any angels. There isn't any supernatural." The Pharisees said, "Well, there is, but you got to check with us before we'll say it was of God or not." How many has ever sat in Pharisee doctrine? You was all right as long as you went through their checklist. But how many know that sometimes the Holy Ghost is so fresh you don't have time to run it through an editor? I think it's wonderful that people make blunders in their speech when they're prophesying. It lets everybody know he's coming hot off the wire and hot off the press. Can you say amen? I think it's good once in a while to start a song in the wrong key and have to change it. Lets everybody know it's not pre-organized and pre-planned. I didn't come here tonight, glory, I feel the Holy Ghost all over me. I didn't come here tonight to figure out what somebody had already arranged. I come to find out what the Lord is saying now. Hallelujah. And so he said, when he got to Jordan, he said the same thing. And look down at verse 6. He said, the Lord sent me to Jordan. And as the Lord liveth and as our soul liveth, I will not leave thee. And they too went on. My God. Now, I've taught you enough to know, praise the Lord, that 1 + 1 in the Bible means 1. Not 2, but 1. And when you read 2 in the Bible, you're headed for one Spirit, one Lord, because 2 shall become 1. Hallelujah. Some folks, just me and Jesus got our own thing going. That ain't the way it is. There ain't but 1. One word from God. One ministry of the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, not twins. You got the Holy Ghost, you got that one, same one I got. And I got the same one you got. And if the same Lord's in you as in me, he that's joined to the Lord. Come on now. There's one Spirit. And so these two went on. Amen. And then they went on, said 50 men, the sons of the prophet, went and stood to view afar off. But these two stood right by Jordan. And Elijah took his mantle, and the King James said, wrapped it together. Other places says, folded it. That'll be very important in a minute. Folded it together and smote the waters. That word smote will be very important in just a moment. Amen. It means he defied their power to operate. He defied death. He stood in the face of death and said, I'm going through you. And you ain't going to have no hold on me. You do understand the test of all life is that it can pass through death and still come out alive. Even in the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, hallelujah, they comfort me. Woo! And so, he said, when they stood afar, when he wrapped his mantle, he hit the waters, they divided hither and thither. Death run from them. Sickness run from them. Disease run from them. Glory to God. Sound like you better get to folding, don't it? Fold it up. Fold up that old way of thinking. Fold up all that old mess that's robbed you. Amen. Now you do understand your only problem tonight is the way you think.
Amen.
And the way you perceive. Perception is your whole key to answered prayer. Amen. I taught you that Sunday, did I not? The man was told go open a new window eastward. Praise the Lord. Perception is the key to answered prayer. How you perceive is how you receive. Amen. And it's through the law of attraction. Whatever you think on, dwell on, meditate on. Whatever you speak, whatever you listen to, whatever you think about, that's what comes your way. Because you're a creator. Praise his holy name. Olamai Shataya, you're a creator. You're made in the image and in the likeness of God himself. Not just in looks. He ain't got no looks. He's a spirit. If I'm in his image and likeness, it must mean I've got his power. I've got his nature. I've got his name. I've got his authority. I've got his dominion. And if I fold up this old mindset, hallelujah, and I pop that mess and say, get out of my way. It'll have to part one way, one the other way. And I'm going over into a new ministry and a new realm and a new level. Every time anybody goes into Jordan, There's death, burial, and resurrection every time. Praise the Lord. Whether it's Israel at Joshua's crossing, whether it's Jesus at John's baptism, or whether it's Naaman getting rid of his leprosy. Praise the Lord. He dipped 7 times in the glory. And God shed death right off of him in that water. And he come up a brand new man with skin like a baby. Death left him. Praise God forever. Because the word of the Lord that the prophet gave him sustained him. And he was all right to go in the waters and come out. And it's the same thing as where Jesus, the psalmist said, Jesus, thou will not leave my soul in hell, nor suffer thy holy one to see corruption. And you say, praise the Lord. And incidentally, in John, in Revelation 1, when the Lord said, I'm he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys. He did not say the word grave in that verse. No, sir. You go back and read it. He said death and hell.
Yes, he did. Praise God.
Because that word hell there means a grave.
Yes, it does.
It means the place of darkness. The place of, amen, the place of departure.
Yes,
the place of separation. It don't say nothing about grave there. Praise the Lord. And you can check me out while I'm preaching if you want to, but it ain't there. And if you find it there, I'll just turn around and go home tonight. But I won't have no worries because it ain't there. It said death in hell. And I have the key of David. And Amos said, I'm going to rebuild the tabernacle of David. And Acts 3 says the same thing. I'm going to rebuild the tabernacle of David. He's got the key of David. That's the throne. Well, glory. So anyway, these are wonderful things tonight. I don't believe I'll read no further because I doubt I'll get any further than where I've read. But we was discussing the last time we was together about how every person had access to the same supernatural anointing that Elisha was going after, yet in 3 distinct locations where there was a school of prophets. That means Elijah circuited to Jericho, Bethel, and Gilgal. Every time he come through there, he taught them how to flow in the Spirit of God. And not a one of them laid hold of that anointing. Elisha was not part of the plan. He was, hallelujah. You remember when Moses asked the Lord to partake of his spirit and put it on the 70? And the Bible said while it was falling on the 70, there's 2 more running outside that wasn't even a part of the meeting. And the Spirit of God fell on them and they got to prophesying. And one of them came to Moses and said, there's 2 men out there wasn't in the meeting. They're prophesying. What you want us to do? You want us to stop them? And Moses said, no, I would to God. Come on now. I would to God all the Lord's servants was prophets. They was all 50 in every place. Bless your heart. 50's half 100. Stuck in the middle. Can't go no further. Saved, sanctified, satisfied, petrified.
Yeah.
Amen. Just Pentecostal. Bless God, I got the Holy Ghost. I know it. You've had it 40 years and hadn't moved.
Yeah.
Offered some, hadn't prayed no different. Hadn't learned one thing new in 40 years, except all you can tell me is you're prayed up, paid up, and ready to go up. Praise the Lord. You know, like the woman got up in the country church I tell you about, that the what was them folks' name that sang for Taranjo, told that Clarence and Armalee. And Armalee said, this old woman jumped up, said, I'm saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, packed up, prayed up, ready to go up, and said by that time we didn't have no windows in the place, just a shotgun church open, said a covey of quail was in the bush beside the window where she was testified. Had them long cut out windows, said they all come up, and when it did, her name was Bess, said she jumped right out the window. Come around, come back in, told everybody, said, that's just how it be. Said, one day old Bess be here and one day old Bess be gone. Amen. I just tell you, some folks, that's the extent of their testimony. I've been sitting here waiting on, you ain't waiting on nothing. You got half of 100 won't do. You got to go all the way into that most holy place and find out your real purpose in this earth. Come on now, it's not to sell fire insurance, but to ignite people with a passion for God and get their eyes open to see that there's 6 billion purposes planted only on one planet in the galaxy, and the planet's Earth, and the purpose is people. Hallelujah. If God was done with us, why in the name of heaven does he keep reproducing life in this earth? My God, oh glory, think on that for a while. He keeps reproducing it, keeps. Somebody said, oh, he can't stop. Sure he could. He made Michael barren, didn't he? He could stop it in a minute, but he still allows mankind to bring life forth into this earth because he's still got a purpose, and he's still got a plan, and he's still got a destiny. Can you say praise the Lord? So anyway, this man's going on, and the first place he comes to, the first place that he's going to have to make a decision whether he's going to go or stay is at Gilgal. That's where the first test of truth was. Now the name itself means rolled away, because it's where the Lord rolled away the reproach of Egypt off of Israel. But it's also the breaking of new ground, because it's the first land they put their feet on. Well, glory to God. It's the threshold. Amen. It's the place of decision. And you know how many is in that valley, don't you? Multitudes trying to make their mind up. Whether they'll cast their lot with the high calling of God in Christ Jesus, or whether they'll die in that old system. Praise the Lord. They'll have a lot of flowers. They'll sing pretty songs. And they'll eulogize you wonderful. But my God, while others are crossing in, you'll be in the ground awaiting on the resurrection in the future. Hello. I believe I'll go ahead and let resurrection. Well, glory. I think I'll go ahead and let it work on me right now. I believe that same spirit. I said, I believe that same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in me. And he's quickening my mortal body right now. Can you say amen? I believe even while I stand before you, the cells and the atoms in my body are being renewed under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I believe I'm adding longevity to my physical life by standing here in the will of God tonight. Yes, I do. Hallelujah. Now, it's the mark of a new generation coming in, circumcision. Them people hadn't never been in there before. They'd never been circumcised before. They're a brand new breed. You think about that. God won't let a generation in, but he will use them to breed the bunch that's going to go in. Hallelujah. They'll go on, and they have gone on, and they've got their reward tonight. Hello? And they too will receive, praise the Lord, this gospel we're preaching tonight, because everybody is going to be a meeting in the air. One bunch is going up and one bunch is coming down. The saints here is going up and the new Jerusalem's coming down from God out of heaven. You better believe they're going to meet. They're going to run right in together. And then, oh my God, be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Somebody say praise the Lord. Shoo. As bad as you want to get over there, they want to get back over here. They know where the kingdom is coming forth at. They know this is the hour to teach it and preach it. And all you that cower and hide under them blankets of religion, you're going to have to give your blankets up. Because the Bible said in Isaiah 30, a bed's going to get so shorter than a man can stretch himself, and the cover scenario can't cover up with it no more. We ain't going to be able to hide out in the corner. We're going to have to announce to somebody that a new day has dawned in this day, and it holds a new ministry and a new priesthood and a new anointing and a new word from heaven. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God.
Amen.
Well, it's the truth. And so, praise the Lord. I'm going to give you a little far faith for some of you not, but it's so anyway. You'll get all right after a while. I'm bound to say something and pull you back in. It was the moving away. The circumcision is the moving away. It typifies a new birth and resurrection through water baptism.
Praise God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Paul taught this. This ain't no new gospel. He said the circumcision by water, meaning the old man's washed away.
Yes,
and the new man. Yes. Romans 6 says it this way. Boy, the anointing got on Chris Sunday and he was talking about this blood, water, and spirit.
Woo.
My God, we had us a time, didn't we? Then we carried it right on over into everybody shouting. Hallelujah. All thinking about, he said, if you be planted together in the likeness of his death, you shall be raised up in the likeness of his resurrection.
Amen.
To walk with him in newness of life. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. That water applied. There's something comes off of you. There's something washes away from you. Jesus said, suffer it to be so, for thus it fulfilleth all righteousness. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Ooh, I like the way Chris said that Sunday morning. We going to have baptism, and we don't care what form it's in. We're going to acknowledge it, whether it's by water or whether it's by spirit. We believe in all of it. In fact, we believe in three different baptisms. We believe in a baptism of water, a baptism of spirit, and a baptism of fire. Hallelujah. We need it all. I said we need it all. And when you enter that water in the name of the Lord and identify with the Lordship of Christ, take on his name, his nature, you're his bride, you ain't ashamed of his name, suddenly this new revelation takes hold of you and you say, my God, I'm one with him now. I've taken on his name. I've taken on his nature. I've taken glory to God. There's a newness that comes with it. So that, you know, that's one thing. There's six actual things that gave them a foundation to stand on at Gilgal, and one of them was that they built a memorial out of 12 stones. They went and took 12 stones out and built it. Amen. They were erected. The stones where the priesthood had stood by faith. Glory be to God. And then the circumcision. And the reproach of Egypt rolled away. That's the third thing. You can't go into new territory grieving what you left behind. Oh, Shana Mahaya. Paul said, I loose all that that's behind me. I forget it. And I reach out unto that which is before me. You can't grieve the good or the bad. You can't wish you'd have stayed nowhere. Would to God we'd have stayed in Egypt. He said, or buried us properly. They brought us out here because there wasn't enough graves in Egypt. God gave them quail and they crawled out of their nose, the Bible said. Yeah, said, run out of their noses. Are you hearing me? And every day they chided. And every day they murmured. And every day they complained. And every day they raised their voice against the ministry that was leading them to a better way. Somebody say praise the Lord. And 3 million of them passed away. Glory to God. But God's raised up a new generation now. And it's going to be a generation of faith. Hallelujah. They're not going to grieve what they left behind because they didn't leave nothing behind. Praise the Lord. Now you won't like this one, but it's so anyhow. They learned the principle of tithing. Because Achan went and put his hands on the first fruits. And God said, where you go, the first fruit belongs unto me. And so we find out that tithing is not about you going and figuring up percentage and trying to round it off and get it just right. Tithing is you giving it before anything else gets a hold of it. It's the first fruits. Come on now. And God's man who goes on into this new day ain't going to have no trouble giving the Lord what's rightfully his to begin with. I don't know about you, but I don't care to peddle stolen goods. I won't give the Lord what's his and not go by what I want with God's portion. I'm preaching now, you just don't know it. So they learned that. Then number five, the manna ceased. They started eating old corn, mature word. God said, I ain't going to just throw it in your lap now. You're going to get revelation by doing what? This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. And if you'll meditate in it. He said, I'll make your way successful and prosperous. Is that the word of the Lord? Now, how many of you know that God don't just drop revelation in your lap like it's a jug, you know, like it's a jug of honey, but you meditate on that. Well, this is the truth. You start getting a sanctified imagination. Everything you picture in your mind has to do with the goodness of God. David said, I'd fainted unless I believed to see the goodness. I don't know if I'm preaching to you, but I'm making me happy right now. I'd fainted unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. How many know the Bible said, be not deceived. God is not mocked. That a man soweth shall he also reap. And if you sow to the flesh, you shall of the flesh reap corruption. But if you sow to the Spirit, you shall reap life everlasting. Therefore, be not weary in well-doing, for in due season you shall reap if you faint not. Hallelujah. Amen. There's a way to press in. There's a way to cross over. There's a way to come on into this thing. It don't have to be some memorial you view from afar off and honor the men that get there. But you can, by faith, pull yourself up and get high in God and march your way past all of the blunders and mistakes and the failures of the past and embrace a new day ahead of you in God. Hallelujah. You can go forth in His name and conquer. Hallelujah. Woo! Be thou strong and of a very good courage, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest, and as I was with Moses, so shall I be with thee. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. He told Joshua right in the middle of the process, get up and look, there still remaineth very much more land to be possessed. I'm trying to tell you, there ain't no setting down. God's changing our diet. Finally, the captain of the Lord's host showed up at Gilgal, which means, speaks of a supernatural strategy or plan, my God, given to us for ultimate victory. None of this start and stop. Go out leaping and come back limping. But a supernatural strategy for complete and total victory. Can you say amen? Oh my God, isn't that wonderful? And Bethel, that's the next place. You know what Bethel means, house of God. But it speaks of the body of Christ, the corporate anointing. A real prophetic anointing will recognize connections always. Listen to me, preacher. You can't preach if people don't come hear you. And you can't prophesy if you ain't got nobody to prophesy to. And you singers can't sing if ain't nobody to sing to. It takes a Bethel experience. It takes you realizing when God connects you to a house, a ministry, a body, an assembly. Hello. And you lose that vision of it being your. Now, I'm going to preach something here to you that'll help you. Your ministry. There ain't no such thing as your ministry, my ministry, his ministry, her ministry. The minister's the body. We're all connected. And the sooner these people that bring revival in their suitcase realize that it takes every member of the body of Christ to produce the right anointing, the sooner we'll all come into the unity of the Spirit and the faith. Hallelujah. Anywhere I'm called to go, I'm sent there for one reason, to bless the body of Christ. I'm not sent there to multiply my own tactics, make my own name known. And the worst thing you can do to any ministry is to go in and act like they ain't got nothing and you got everything. When you do that, you just shut the door on yourself. You slam the door in your own face. Can you say amen? Honor them for what they do have.
That's right. Exactly.
Preach to them what they do know. And get a few sticks in when the Lord opens the window. Because if the window ain't open, it'll just fall like, just drop to the ground. You ain't supposed to cast your pearls before the swine. Can you say amen? The Bethel step makes me realize that the entire body of Christ, fully anointed and fully aware of what God is doing in this present hour. This present hour. Me being anointed to make everywhere I go and everything I say help people be made aware of what God is presently doing right now in His church. Not what He has done, not what He will do, but what He is presently doing among His people. You understand that? That's the Bethel experience. You'll find a house or an assembly with a set man or woman that God has appointed. You'll honor it with your time, your money, your prayers, your faith. You'll have faith in that place.
Amen.
You'll have faith in their prayers. When you get in a place you need the touch of God, you'll call on them and then you'll believe that they're going to touch God. Ooh, hallelujah. In your behalf. My God. How many believes it tonight? You'll labor in it and for it. You'll worship in it. Amen. It'll be your connection to the very blessing of God. And when you connect with it, it'll connect with you. And you won't be out peddling, trying to find a way to get blessed. You'll have the blessing of the Lord in your life. But then finally, or thirdly, he come to Jericho. Jericho means the fragrant place. Amen. It's the place of fragrance. It's the place of a palm tree too. That's one of the names of which means the place of worship and maturity. Now it's the place of unity for a whole host of people worship together in one mind of silence for 7 days. They never uttered a word. They were unified in their silence. I can't get that, couldn't get that to happen in 10 people. I don't know how. It had to be God for 3 million of them to march for 7 days and never open their mouth because they were so sure God was going to honor His word. For He said, shout, I've already given you the city. They were so submitted to spiritual authority, they awaited the sound of the trumpet before they made. Everybody ain't going to do that. Come on now. Some folks ain't going to submit to nothing. Just as sure as you tell them not to, they're going to. And just as sure as you tell them to do it, they ain't going to do it. They're not submitted in no kind of way to spiritual authority. The anointing of God is moving in this place, and I see people go in direct insubordination to yielding to that anointing. Doesn't matter whether it's against me, it's never against me. Because I'm the anointed vessel for that time, so it's always against the anointing, never against the person. You may think you're going against the person, but you're never going against the person. You're going against the call and the anointing. This is wrong. There are many people in this earth that I will bow my knee to in their presence of their anointing and let them prophesy the world over me, but I cannot stand them. Yeah. As a person, I have no use for them. Yeah. But I'm smart enough to know it ain't got nothing to do with whether I like them or whether I blow glory or dislike them. It's that they're chosen of God for this time and this hour. Can you say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. Now, I'm a lot sweeter than I have been. I hope a little wiser. When I first started preaching, people would do that junk all the time. Amen. And I'd just get on there until I run them out. Then I'd have church after they left. But now I've tried to have patience. Praise the Lord. Let patience have her perfect work. Praise the Lord. And I try to look beyond one or two thorns and see that there's a big picture out here. And if I'll just stay with God, He will bring the majority of us into this place that I'm speaking about. Amen. But if you believe in that anointing, you'll submit to authority. If the man of God's marching, you'll march. That's what they did. The priest marched ahead of them, and they marched. He didn't say nothing. They didn't say nothing. He worshiped. They worshiped. My God, are you listening to this? And then the day He did blow, all of them didn't have to be told to shout. The man of God made noise, so they made noise. And when they made noise, God made noise. And the walls fell flat. Amen. Shout, I've already given you the city. Now finally, they come, told you I wouldn't get past the Jordan. They get to the Jordan. And the Jordan means descending or descender, and is associated, we know this, with death. Here, the sons of the prophets stood and watched from afar off. When it gets real, real, you know, they'll back away. You can tell when it's that old, just noise. My wife and I one time went to this tent meeting, and I didn't know the preacher, and we were sitting in the, and some other evangelist was there that we knew, and I sat down. As soon as I sat down, I got a bad feeling. I said, I ain't got no business here. This ain't even real. And about that time, the preacher come to the side of the tent. He was talking, cutting up, joking with people. And then when he seen the service was running a little slow, he grabbed a tambourine, went dancing across there, stirring up the dust. Boy, I punched her and said, get up and let's get out of here. And we got up and left. The brother behind us said, where are you going? I said, this ain't for me, brother. I'm going. I left. We went to another meeting one time and with a renowned preacher to some. Probably wouldn't nobody hear no much about him, but he is a shyster, all right. And we walked in, just never even got a seat, just turned around and walked back out. I could sense that spirit wasn't right out of that. They were just wrong atmosphere, you know. Well, if you find out, if a man's got any of the Holy Ghost, he knows what the atmosphere is. He can discern the atmosphere. And so these sons of the prophet couldn't discern nothing. All they knew was, you don't mess with that Jordan. We're afraid of that Jordan. Get back away and view from afar off. That man's crazy is what they were saying. Here he's going, who does he think he is? Approaching that anointing like that. Why, we've been here prophesying. But yeah, you sure have for 20 years. Ain't moved a stitch off of that spot you've been on. But here comes a new man in town who don't know any better than to press on through, hallelujah, with the prophet of God, and decide to make up his mind he's going in all the way. They feared death. They took notice of the new ministry that drew near to the Jordan. And just as the priest came to the Jordan in the book of Joshua, Elijah and Elisha come to the brink of the Jordan. Come on. At this moment, Elisha is faced with the last opportunity to bail out. They ain't no boats. They ain't no rafts. There ain't no way to get back over except for him to attain that high anointing while he's on the other side. Because if the Lord's going to take his master away, he's got to get back over among this. And the only way he'll get back over is to exercise the supernatural anointing of God to get him back across there. If there's any jumping off to do, if you're going to bail out, here's the place to do it. Amen. Here's the place to do it. And so, you know, the only way he's going to get back over is to obtain the same ministry and the same power. Praise the Lord. Jesus went over and come back alive forevermore. He's going to have a people that can get over and not do like everybody else has done. Most folks goes over, don't get back. Hello? They await a better resurrection for another hour, another time. But God's going to have a man.
Yes, he is.
Are you listening to me? That's even going to raise the dead from the earth.
Yes,
he's going to go over and come back. And death ain't going to have no power over it. Amen? They're going to have power over all sickness, power over all disease, power over all infirmity, power over all the power of the enemy, is the way Jesus described it. I give you power over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Praise the Lamb of God. And he's going to have it. If it came out of his mouth, then it has to come to pass. If God said it, shall he not do it? Hath he spoken, shall he not make it good? Oh, glory to God. My God, get out of the sandbox. Quit playing in the play yard. Get on up here in this graduating class and find out what it takes to get a diploma. Oh, hallelujah. Find out what the Lord will require of thee to go over to the other side. Hallelujah. Lord, have mercy. said, you know, Jesus went down in the river and was buried. But at the same time, he come up and a voice spoke from heaven. The heavens were open. And they never shut again. And the Holy Ghost ascended in bodily form like as a dove. And a voice spoke from heaven and said, this is my beloved Son, and I'm in him, in whom I am. Well pleased. He never walked through water again, did he? He walked on the water. He never did let water splash on him again. He had authority even over the elements of the earth. I don't mean a supernatural God, you can't see. I mean a flesh man. Come on now. He didn't do that as just a God you can't see. That word became flesh and dwelt among us. He did what he did as a 100% man of faith. Oh, Abba-Sata. He didn't do it as some supernatural deity and entity that is separated from you and me. He became the likeness of mankind himself, and I've got that same thing in me that he had in him, and you've got that same thing in you that he had in him. Well, glory to God. Look up here while I preach. I'm preaching the truth to you. My God, don't ignore me while I talk. Honor the man of God tonight. I'm under the anointing for God's sake. I'm not playing tiddlywinks. I'm telling you, there's a people that God's raising up. I ain't playing games with you. I'm serious. I'm under an anointing right now. From the top of my head to the soles of my feet. And I'll not be defied in this atmosphere. It'll be the word of the Lord or nothing. Hallelujah. I feel a prophet's anointing. I feel the glory of the Lord. I feel the river rising. I feel the saints pressing. Hallelujah. Lord God, folks, if you're going to come here, get something. Shalabahosai. Edomahanda. Orabashatai. Oh, my God. Woo. Edomahasa. I could cross over in some of that water right now. I feel that close to it. Woo, that same thing that's in him is that same thing that's in me and that same thing that's in you. Woo, hey, I'm a Sata. Oh, that same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you. Ooh, I'm seeing in another place. I'm telling you tonight, I've crossed over to another realm. I'm tired of this realm that holds us back. I'm tired of these chains that hold us back. I'm tired of these thoughts that lie to us and talk us out of it. I still believe God's working out a plan. I still believe God's devising a church. I still believe he's raising up a man. I'm not talking about one little man that lives on a hill somewhere. I'm talking about there's a mighty man of God made up of many members. Oh, glory to God. Getting ready to get up in this earth. That mighty man of valor. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory to God. Who's got the whole armor of God. Oh, my God. Oh, Lord. Hey, Ephesians 4 said before he ascended, he descended. He come down here. Ooh, God. I said he come down here. He made a step over. He left it all behind. He got a shundai. He left it. He become a man. He become like the seed of Abraham. He become like the seed of David. He become a priest after the order of Melchizedek, who's able to give life. Glory to God. Never ending life. And he came to his own. And his own received him not. But unto them that did receive him. Woo! I said unto them that did receive him. To them gave he the power. Oh, glory to become the sons of God. To become the offspring. To become the headway. To become that new people. That new generation. Who manifest God in this earth. He ain't got no legs but my legs. He ain't got no hand but my hand. He ain't got no voice but my voice. He's invested all that he is in his church. Ooh, I say, he's invested all that he is in his church. He'll not doubt a voice. Oh, God. Yea, the Kushana. Hakarataya. Ilakasanda. Ramanje the Makusakaramaha. Hey, keep the Andalamasa. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Ava Boshanda, for the word of the Lord would speak unto thee this night and say, my daughter, though this journey hath been long and though this battle hath been loud, yet have I not been with thee every step of the way, and I have led thee and I have guided thee, saith the Lord, and I brought thee to the very place that thou art in this night, saith God, and I do open up a new well within thee this night, saith the Lord, and I remove all the dirt and all the debris, and yea, I cause thee to ride on the high places of the earth, saith God. I lift thy feet up this night, I set them down in a new territory, and thou shalt inherit a greater dimension, for I, the Lord thy God, have spoken this thing unto thee, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. And the Lord thy God would speak and say unto thee, I'm not only a God that begins it, but I am a God that completes it. And yea, that I have begun, I will be faithful to perform it unto the day, saith God. And yea, thy day is straight ahead of thee, saith God. Thy best days are not behind thee, but yea, thy best days are in front of thee, saith God. And this night I'm giving thee a new lease, a new hold, and a new anointing, and thou shalt walk on out in the deeper things of thee, saith the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Hora mashanda. Hey, come on, son. Amen, amen, amen. I see the Lord adjusting your eyes in the spirit just like you adjust a microscope. Woo! I see him turning knobs. I see him turning knobs. I see him getting it clear. But he ain't just getting it clear, he's magnifying it. And the Lord said an anointing of magnification is coming upon thee this night, saith God. And yea, where it has looked little, it shall look big. Woo! Where it has looked small, it shall look great and vast. For I shall do a large thing, saith the Lord. He come out and I am the Lord that healed thee. I'm the Lord that has given thee back thy health, and it has not been given to be taken away. And yea, I renew my covenant with thee this night, saith God, and thy body shall respond to it, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Shakamahanda. He come rastondo roboshe. Lift your hand and love him. Lift your hand and praise him. And I ask the Lord to get in the middle with a bulldozer and make a way where there seemed to be no way. Woo, I ask him to bring it by the supernatural, by the impossible, right out of the blue. I thank him right now because a new thing is coming. Woo, I lay hold of it in the spirit tonight. A new thing. Hallelujah. Shook him a hold of it. Worship God. It ain't like normal, but let it be abnormal for a while. We need something to shake us. Hallelujah. Shook him a hold of it. You're receiving healing in your kidneys. Healing in your kidneys. Right now. I see the power of God like a light over both of your kidneys, and God is working a miracle even now. Oh, Shamahanda, the pain is leaving, and the discomfort is leaving, and the pressure is leaving. Hallelujah! And you are healed in the name of the Lord. Oh, Kabasanda. Hey, I don't know nothing. I just know God right at this minute. I don't want to know nothing. Said Jesus Christ and him crucified. Soko Roboshea. Ikara Talamasata. Ukavrastondo. Ilamashanda. Andalama. Come here, let me prophesy to you. The Lord, this prophecy, I've been giving you words about business, but this prophecy is about the ministry. This is about the ministry. And the Lord said, the ministry is going to sprout new wings, and they're prophetic wings. And the Lord would say unto thee that what thou experienced Sunday morning was just a foretaste of a new anointing that is coming upon thy voice. And even as thou art teaching and preaching in a normal stance, yea, behold, the prophetic shall take thy voice over, and it will be nothing of which you'll have a warning, nothing of even which you'll have a sign, but it shall come upon thee suddenly, says the Lord. Yea, thy mouth shall be turned into another mouth, and thy tongue shall be made the pen of a ready writer, and thy voice shall become my trumpet. And yea, thy mouth my oracle, saith God. And I will speak forth new things, and yea, even mysterious things that have been hid from every other generation, even from thee. But they shall come forth, and thou shalt not have any control over it, but it shall be a supernatural right now word that will lift the people into a greater dimension. This night do I ordain thee in the prophetic, saith God, and dimensions of glory unknown shall come unto thee from this night forward, saith the Lord. And yea, you shall find, Habasata, that every day shall be ministry day, because I'm going to talk a lot, saith Tabataya. In the next 30 days, I will talk a lot. New things will I declare unto thee, saith the Lord thy God. Brand new things, brand new revelations, brand new gold. But it's gold I've got out of the fire, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Rostatoya. Legalabanji. Rastanini Akorianda Salamate Rosto Yamandaya. Ha Shabahai. Ha Shabahai. Ha Shabahai. Let worship him, worship him, worship him, worship him, worship him. My God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Hekalini, ha 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 ha. Mashakarabatatataya, Roshamahoya. So if you can stand without disturbing that anointing, do so and just worship. 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 I saw in the Holy Ghost here plain as day, I saw a man on a bulldozer. The Lord said he's pushing things out of the way. I mean, I saw literally in the spirit somebody coming up a hill with a bulldozer. Brother, that means there's a way being made. New way for this new day. For this new way of life. Oh, shababababababariti oda bohoya. Shoo, shoo. Sukamahande. Hakamahande. If you can do it, you'll translate into a new realm of God tonight. You can step right on over. Oh, Shabraste. Lekalini Maja. Magabrondo Kosibrete. Lekebriostuna. Akalamanje. Ekalamanzidi. Asatoradea. Right now's the time to be in on this. This is deep stuff. Get in on it right now. Get spiritual. Sakamahana. 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 Kabasokan. See in the spirit of you. Few more moments. Oh, Shabbahai. Let that intercession come on. Kokariti Orabo Shete. Kapriostoya. Lakakarete Kefriha. Oh, Shabande Alabahai. Woo, Sakariti Orabahai. Woo, Shakamana. Sakabadoshi. Sakabadoshi. Sakaradoshi. Sakariti Koramande, Pasapora de Arabangeli Andoro, Woo Sakamande, Oh
Marry me multiply and replenish in the earth realm. This is not about anymore what you can get to appease your flesh and make your own self feel better temporarily. But this is about those who will become one with me to the point that they become one just like me to replenish and reproduce myself in the earth. Those who will walk in a state of marriage, contentment, commitment, faithfulness to the point that I will increase them because my kingdom is increasing through them in the earth.
Yes. And I heard the Lord say that He's going to fill the streets with the sound of new children. And the virgin and the bride are going to join arm in arm. And they're going to dance for joy in the street because a birthing has come forth. And yea, saith the Lord, I'll fill the streets with laughter. And I'll fill the streets with rejoicing. And there'll be no sound of war heard, nor rumors of war, saith the Spirit of God. But yea, I'll silence every other voice but that voice, saith the Spirit of God. I will silence it. I'll cut it off. I'll defeat it and I'll destroy it. And the only voice you will hear is the voice and the sound of the bridegroom, saith the Lord. And it'll be a sound that'll fill every house with joy.
Absolutely.
And these families that are in my kingdom shall not only survive, they shall thrive. Because I will put an anointing on them of acceleration, saith God. And yea, know this night that thy feet is known. Take a few steps. Take a few steps. Come back a few. Sit down a few. Rest a while. Gather up strength for a new day. But I say unto me, they shall not walk that way, no way. I am putting an acceleration. I am putting a lightness to thy feet. And yea, ye are going to get that skipping anointing. For yea, did not my voice skip and leap upon the hills? And yea, I am getting ready to bring you to that high place. And you shall run on the hills with me and look at things from my point of view, saith the Lord. And you shall see every enemy defeated. And you shall see every cause resurrected. And you shall see the hearts of the fathers turn to the children and the hearts of the children turn to the fathers. For I will hasten these things to perform thee, and I'll do a quick work. I'll not strain this out, saith God. Yea, this shall not be a work of many years, but I'll do a quick work. I'll do a quick work, and I'll cut it short in righteousness, and I'll look in you to find that righteousness in which I shall cut it short. For you are surely my righteousness, and I've declared and deemed thee worthy to receive of this covenant of the household of faith, saith God. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. We've worshiped Him now. Just praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Thank Him. Oh, glory. Thank Him. Praise Him. Shoot. I tell you, I don't know what come a hold of me. Whatever it was from another world. I'm kind of back in myself now, but I've got up where I didn't even know what I was doing. Amen. Maybe he has to do it that way. So he can say what he wants to say. I don't know. But anyway, I don't be held accountable for nothing I've said in the last 20, 25 minutes. Or somewhere or another, I kind of hit another rap. Amen. Shoot. My whole body translated. I felt like I was going and couldn't get back. Glory to God. I felt like I had to grab the bench just to stay with you all. But I wasn't going there in the natural. I was going there in the supernatural. Oh, my God. Ha! I breathe a wild feeling again. Glory. Shaka Mahane Roto Rabolia Mande. Hallelujah. Woo. My God, let it be. Every night, every day, every service. Higher and higher. Deeper and deeper. Moving in the realms of glory. He's calling his own. We'll not come down from the high places. We've been caught up with Jesus. I said we've been caught up with Jesus in the realms. My God, we've never known. Never known. Never known. Whoa, the Lord's saying you do not sit down here with me while I make your enemies your footstool. So yonder. Now listen, when atmosphere bodies come in, I'll just tell you this and then we'll go home. When times like this move in upon you, you don't have to wait on me to address your healing. You just get healed. You don't have to wait on me to address your finances. You can just break poverty right off of it. You don't have to wait on me to give you a word of direction. You can get your direction instantaneously in the glory. That's where it's all at, in the glory. In the glory. In the glory. Somehow, as I've begun to talk about Jesus becoming that man and giving us that same glory, I just sure slipped over. Hallelujah. I was able to see that. I've preached it, but I was able to see somehow, and I can't explain to you what I saw. But I can't talk much about it either. I go down in the spirit. I get drunk just thinking about it. I said I get drunk just thinking about it. Somehow or another I connected for what he wanted me to connect with. Bless you. Hallelujah. Somehow or another God got it over to my spirit what he wants us to see concerning how he did what he did in the same facility. That's what we're in right now. Brother Britton called it Sons of God Awake. That trumpet wakes you up. Something says to you, it's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. He said, praise the Lord. No wonder when they said, John, we got trouble. He said, what's the trouble? There's a man named Jesus over there baptizing more than you do. Amen. And most churches don't even know that. They'll tell you Jesus never baptized anybody. That's not true. They said, John, Jesus is baptizing. And John said, how could the friend of the bridegroom bemoan the voice of the bride? He said, I rejoice, he said, at the voice of the bridegroom, for I must decrease. I must decrease, and he must increase. God, that ain't just talking about you taking a little devotional and trying to do better. That's talking about in a meeting like this tonight, you learning how to leave yourself behind and get over into the super, get over into the supernatural. My God, they call on my seeking. Go to Boshende. My God, my God, my God. I mean that. I don't mean that in a derogatory sense. I'm saying it out of my soul tonight. My God. My Lord and my God. Well, glory. Don't just touch his hands. Don't just touch his feet. Thrust your hand. Woo. Woo. Hallelujah. Thrust your hand deep in his side. See if you can find that place where you've chosen in him before the foundation of the world. See if you can get a hold of that identification that makes you stand redeemed in this earth and certified to produce the greater works ministry. The greater works ministry. Hallelujah. Now, Lord, I can do nothing with this. I don't even know how to turn it loose. But I will believe that if you hadn't did it all you was going to do, you'll keep doing it. Even on the way home with people. Let them fear your glory. May the glory do like it did in Ezekiel's day of the river. May it flow out from under the threshold of this building. Go on out with the people of God tonight. And Lord God, accomplish much great, mighty things. Oh, I'm not looking at a bunch of weaklings.
No.
I'm looking at mighty men of valor. I want you to know that tonight. Every one of you that have heard and said and listened are going to reap benefits. Forget not all his benefits. He daily loadeth us with benefits. Hallelujah. Now we'll pray together tomorrow at 7:30, and then we'll be back here Sunday morning at 10 o'clock. Until then, we don't know where we'll be, but we'll be in him some way. Praise the Lord. May God talk to us all night long. And when this Abraham man, this seed of Abraham goes to sleep, may the Spirit come on forth and commune. David said one time, I commune with my own spirit. Hallelujah. Let that go on all night. God giving us revelation. Bless you tonight. Amen.